Well, hello everybody, this is Richard here, and this is part 5 of the Columbia Glorfonia 118. And this afternoon I thought I'd just update you about where we are with things, only a short update. But before then I thought I'd talk about a lovely evening I had at the Pizza Express in Maidstone. They've got a Pizza Express music room there, and I've been there a few times with family and we had a really lovely time. I was lucky enough to see Digby Fairweather and the All-Stars, and actually in the break I was very lucky that I was able to meet Digby and actually chat to him about some of his experience in the jazz world. One of the things that he did, he actually spoke to me about Nat Goner, because I said that I enjoyed 1920s through to 1940s dance band, and he said he knew Nat for about 20 years and they worked very closely together up to his death, and said to me that he'd actually send me a book that he'd written, co-authored with another guy, and so I thought I'd mention that this afternoon. The actual book itself is with Ron Brown, it's this one, and I haven't read anything about it. I haven't started reading it yet, but I certainly think it's worth getting. So if you're interested at all in getting interested in dance band music, and particularly about Nat, then I mean, I'll put the link at the bottom as it says down there, but it's Digby Fairweather Productions, so, and that you can get. So, but it's a lovely, there's some nice photographs in here. I'm currently reading the life story autobiography about Lou Stone, and had the wonderful experience of going on the Memory Lane London El Bowley walk last Saturday, and also which also included the visit to St. Sophie's Greek Orthodox Cathedral, which was an amazing experience. Such a lovely place, full of mosaic murals in there and artifacts, and very, very nice. We were very lucky because we arrived there and some of the group got ahead of Ray Pallett and I and the other members that were coming round with us on the tube, and so they the priest was just about to lock up, so we were very lucky to have a private viewing, which I think was absolutely marvellous. So but really a lovely experience. But I thought perhaps before I start talking about the 118, I'd just play you a little bit of Digby this afternoon on the Sony. So I'm going to do that. So just bear with me a second while I set that up. So where are we? There we go. And have a slurp of tea. Okay, so I'm just going to take Mr. GoPro off his stand and without turning him off, and so I can show you just. Bear with me a second. Oh, there's the cup of tea there. Right, so we're in the Sony there. A vertical player, CD player. Let's put my tea down. So let's plug him in. I'm going to play you number 4, which is The Very Thought of You, as this is a dance band track. So let me just locate that. There we go, and it's telling us that it's on the right track at the bottom there, scrolling. So let's push the play button and enjoy. Thank you.
fantastic. And that was really, really nice. So there we go. That's the back sleeve of the CD. There's also playing with the All-Stars was a gentleman called Dave Shepherd. And I've got him on a second CD I got off the internet on eBay. This was recorded delivery, which was sponsored by, would you believe, none other than the post office. And this gentleman here with the clarinet is actually Dave Shepherd. Dave Shepherd is renowned to be the British Benny Goodman. I have to say that I definitely would agree with that, because some of the pieces he played on Saturday were as good as Benny, and I just loved, you know, he's not a young man, but they were just so amazing, the whole group. Anyway, just thought that's a sort of parish announcements more than anything else. Now the 118, now as you can see, this is the motorball, the 118. This is a lot different than last time. If you remember, last time I did a video upload, that it was quite rough looking, and I've now given it several coats of varnish, and I've given it a mahogany satin, and then I've covered that after several rub downs with a clear varnish. So I've done that, but the worst bit of all, of course, was the tone arm board, or plinth maybe you call it. I'm not sure what the original title would be, but if I turn this over, you'll see that there was a hole that went right through where the electric tone arm had been fitted. And what I've done is I've filled that in. You can't actually see that. You might just see a slight indentation there, but you can't see that. And I've also rubbed that down several times and then given a coat of clear varnish in the same way. So the two fairly match up. I think there's a fair match there. You've got to be a bit careful. I've also cleaned up some of the other parts. This is the part that goes here for the stay. So that's looking good now. I've cleaned up the speed regulator. So that goes here. The actual motor itself has been completely, now the motor's over here, this one here, I've got it bagged up actually, just keep it. This is doing really well now, this is ready to go, and I should be putting that onto the motor board. And I've got, and I think I mentioned last time, these little bushes, these rubber bushes have really gone all hard. I've got some 3/4 inch tack washers, which funnily enough have a hole in the middle, which I'm going to use to fit on there. And then also I've found another brake, because this is the original one and it's got a bit, the chrome's come off that, and I found in my book, my parts box, this one, which I've cleaned up with some chrome cleaner, and you can see it's really, really sparkly, it's really good. So I'm going to substitute that, and the little leather brake pad is still okay there. Other parts are okay, this just needs cleaning up, and that's part of a bit that goes underneath here for when you're fitting the stay. I need to put a stay, actually. That bit goes to stay, and also there we go. That's the speed regulator, which I've also cleaned up. That fits on this end, this fork end fits onto the governor and then moves up and down and links in with the speed regulator time here. So we're getting there slowly. It's taking a while, obviously. And then yesterday, what I did when I had a bit of time, I found some feet. These feet are completely perished. But I'm actually going to use some felt pads, which I've got from an old speaker I had. And these, I think, will do just as nice for a table, just to stop it scratching. The actual cabinet itself, now if I come outside, cabinet itself, here we go. I've oiled the louvers, which control the sound, loud and soft. So they're working really well now. And also I've taken the horn out and cleaned out all the interior. You have to take this part out to get the horn out. And the horn is a double reflex horn, which I think I mentioned before, and that's here. I've just got to find some screws to fit here for this part. But it's looking good. It's looking good, looking very good. So, and I'm sure the sound is going to be great as well. So, it's quite a lot going on, really, over the last couple of weeks, or a few days. But I thought I'd just give you a quick update and look forward to your comments. Speak to you later.